Hey, what's up? Good evening, people. Today has been a very interesting day. I had two concurrent programs running, and I had to be at one, of course, physically, I had to be at one. So our combined emotional intelligence and anger management certification is ongoing. It's been on since Wednesday. It's finishing tomorrow. And today was the live class for the business study group. I had to be there for about 5 hours. So I had to split my presence. And, coming back from my business study group class and coming back to the combo class, the emotional intelligence class, and finding my facilitators being on fire, engaging the class. It was fun. I was learning from the sessions, a lot of activities, stuff. And I just felt like, wow. See, it feels so good to be a vehicle for someone to make money. It feels so good. And so I thought I should share this video. If you're someone who has an idea, please sit down, build this idea, believe in it, create a system around it, grind and grind and grow and expand. Do as much as you can to create a system around it, then let it fly. It's very important that you become a vehicle for other people to make money. Is a major blessing. Last birthday of Basket Mouth, I was watching on Insta. I was seeing on Instagram a post by Yor. Many of us will know Yor. Yor was thanking Basket Mouth for being a blessing through his TV channel called Flatmates. Flatmates is initiated by Basket Mouth and one other guy. They are the executive producers. And if you see the number of episodes and the money, I guess that the income they make per episode is quite mouth-watering, I want to guess. So, Yor was thanking Basket Mouth for being a blessing because his brainchild has become a vehicle for other people to make money. I feel that way today. I'm so grateful to God. I'm so pleased. I'm so excited that aside the fact that I employ people as a business owner, I've also created systems where other people can make money based on their skill sets, their availability, their passion, their commitment to growth. It's so humbling. So I want to use this as an encouragement to you. That idea that you have that is looking very small, hold it, grow it, iterate it. Keep turning it and turning it and turning it and turning it. Make it expand. Invest time in it. Invest resources in it. Invest knowledge. Invest as much as you can. Partnerships, whatever it takes. Stay true to that commitment and let it expand. Let it grow. Promise yourself to succeed. Give yourself room to grow. See, in the face of attacks, believe in it. Keep doing it. Keep doing it. In the face of contemplation, in the face of doubt, in the face of perspective, whatever the difficulty, hold on to that thing and grow it and let other people benefit from it. Become a vehicle through which other people can be blessed. I tell you, it's humbling, it's fulfilling, and it is of God. Remember, you were created to create. You're not created to just consume. So, in the capacity to create, keep doing it. Though says fear is still crippling some of us, do it afraid. Do it with the fear. The thing is, some of us are not immune to fear. No, we are not. We are not immune to fear. It's just that we have embraced it. We are afraid of failure. We are afraid of being misunderstood. We are afraid of losing money. We are afraid of failing. We are afraid of the fact that can I pay my bills? We are afraid of the future. Oh, my children are growing. Can I afford what they are going to need? We are afraid of so many things. In fact, we are afraid of succeeding. Do you know part of the fear of succeeding? Because someone who is becoming popular will be subject to a lot of ridicule, a lot of pressure, a lot of expectations, a lot of attacks. So, my friend, though, do it afraid. Grab that fear become, make it a part of you, and while being afraid, grow organically. Don't rush, don't jump out of line without reasoning. Take calculated steps, but most importantly, invest in that idea, grow it, believe in it, stay at it. One of the things is you need to grow staying power. Grit is very key. It's not everything that will come easily. In fact, a system that is growing cannot be easy to build. So staying power is key. Perseverance is key. Self-belief is key. Determination is key. Even the fear itself is necessary. You need the fear, because if you're not afraid of things going wrong, you'll be overconfident. And who needs an overconfident businessman? No, we don't need that. We need a businessman that is aware that things may go wrong and is putting in place a structure that does not make it go wrong. So, I appreciate the opportunity to share this thought with you. And I want to thank all of you who have joined. Please, as is our culture, don't forget to share this video. I appeal to you. Please share this video. Thank you for joining. Utibe Basi, it's good to see you. Thank you so much. Thank you. Florence Oki Senior. Florence, thank you for joining, ma'am. Chimezie, good to see you. Omoba Binri Adiola, good to see you. Nancy, good to see you. Anthony Ndubishi, good to see you. My boss, Isaac Onoja, good to see you, sir. Mike Aboche, good to see you. Thank you so much. Please don't forget to share this video. Let someone who is on your timeline have this experience. Don't forget, be a vehicle for someone to make money. And God bless you. Bye.